Kenyan President Uhuru Kenyatta announced restrictions on movement into and out of the capital, Nairobi, and four other counties in a bid to reverse a recent surge in the coronavirus infections. Take a look at a quote from the president. It says, Kenya is squarely in the grip of the third wave of this pandemic. The death rate is devastating by all measures, and the stress the pandemic is placing on our health system is unparalleled. Kenya Airways suspended all domestic flights starting March 29th at midday while international operations continue. The measure comes after the president, Uhuru Kenyatta, announced new restrictions for movement into and out of the capital, Nairobi, due to a surge in coronavirus infections. So what's the impact on Kenya's travel scene and tourism? Joining us to discuss further is Muthuri Kinyamu, co-founder of travel agency Turnup Travel, and he joins us live from Nairobi. Thank you so much for joining us. Good morning, or rather, good afternoon to you in Nairobi. Good morning here. What is the impact of these restrictions, I guess, on tourism in Kenya?
Thank you so much for having me. The immediate impact has been, of course, massive cancellations ahead of the Easter weekend travels. Which of course leads to a lot of loss in terms of livelihoods. A lot of people were just getting back to their employment. Restaurants were absorbing more staff. Now, in the absence of dining in, there is, of course, going to be loss of employment. The curfew starts at 8 p.m., so that again means a lot of the bars that was having on till a bit late will have to lay off people. Bars have also been closed. So that's the immediate. The bigger thing is, of course, the apprehension when it comes to now booking travel, so due to the uncertainty. So it, again, is going to be felt, you know, in the coming weeks.
Thank you for that. So looking at it holistically, how badly was travel and tourism in Kenya affected by the pandemic?
I mean, of course, the restrictions have been very brutal, just like in any other destination worldwide that has, you know, set up some level of, you know, mitigation of the pandemic. Now, Kenya, I would like to say, reopened up our international airspace in August of 2020. So we've seen the number of international arrivals, you know, steadily growing up to the festive season in December. But then again, domestic market supports about over 50% of our bed night occupancy in the country. So again, domestic market has been that lifeline for the industry, you know, in that recovery effort. So I feel, of course, you know, we're looking at about tourism contributing about 10.4% of our GDP here, about which is about 8.8 million, you know, trillion dollars. So that's, of course, and tourism creates one in every 10 jobs. So there has been massive unemployment, loss of income, and lots of course, investors reeling in from the effects, you know, from the economic ramifications of the pandemic.
Wow, that's pretty tough. $8.8 million contribution there to GDP. So would you, okay, so can it be said then that before these latest restrictions announced by President Kenyatta, was travel and tourism on its way to recovery, but as a result of these domestic numbers you're giving us, it wasn't? How would you gauge where things were before these latest restrictions?
Yeah, the recovery, of course, had to start with the domestic market, which has, of course, been steadily growing, even for the last 5 years from 2014. Numbers there were about 4.5 million, you know, in terms of Kenyans traveling within the country. That, of course, went down incredibly. But before the latest restrictions, you know, various stakeholders had done a lot of markets, you know, destination marketing initiatives. I was just at the Getaway Tourism Expo over the weekend, just last Sunday, and lots of hotels were fully booked for the Easter weekend, for example. Now, with the current restrictions, that is all, you know, up in air. So the market was recovering slowly. We had started getting, you know, bookings even for the summer holidays from June. Of course, this is, you know, still there. You can still come to the country. You can still travel into the country and across the country. So we only have a restriction within one zone, which has five counties, you know, so it's Nairobi and our neighboring, like the Nairobi metropolis. So we still hope, you know, even foreigners will still come to the country and enjoy the rest of what we have to offer. And if you're coming to Nairobi, you can still also get access to all these other attractions, activities that are within the one zone that's currently, you know, locked down.
Have there been any bailouts from the government for your sector of tourism?
The Ministry of Tourism set aside about 3 billion Kenya shillings in form of a stimulus package that was for especially soft loans that property owners, mostly hoteliers, would use or borrow to do renovations. And just improve the quality of the, you know, of their properties. In terms of you know, any other form of bailout, there has been, of course, banks restructuring facilities they had, but you know, and you know, like programs like NPACT, which we are part of, that gave us like, you know, a grant of about 10,000 euros. But from the government, there hasn't been really much besides, you know. You know, at the policy level, honestly, for tourism. Yeah.
Thank you so much for that. So that being said, will any lobbying groups from the tourism and, you know, sector be reaching out to government to try to get more assistance?
Yes, that's already happening. So umbrella body for all trade associations is called Kenya Tourism Federation. And they've already, of course, started lobbying for a bit more leniency, a bit more understanding. One, factoring in the bookings that are already locked in, the travelers, especially international, that are already coming into the country. So we already, as I've mentioned before, if you're flying into the country, you can still get to travel into Nairobi and out of Nairobi, even with domestic flights. So the current restrictions affect the Kenyans or residents who are currently in the country. Because again, if you've already been tested for your COVID test and allowed to fly, so you're coming in negative, so you can access literally whatever you had booked. The second thing that we're asking, of course, is for special passes for tourism service vehicles to move around. And sometimes, you know, you have a late flight at 10 p.m. or at 1 p.m., you need to be dropped at the airport. So there will be certain restrictions that will possibly not going to apply to the tourism industry, and we're praying for that. And then there is lobbying currently from KTF.
All right, great stuff. And as far as recovery, what does the recovery look like if things are to pick up? Is it a pickup in these domestic numbers that you've talked about earlier?
Yes, it starts. I mean, you know, it starts at home. Regionally, travel as well. So from our neighbors, Kenya, Tanzania, Ethiopia, and all that. But we've also seen a lot of intra-Africa travel, you know, picking up, you know, say honeymoons from Nigeria, for example. So that was already happening, you know, before these restrictions. But again, that's going to continue because I see, the country is still accessible. You know, our borders are not closed out. There was also, you know, incentive travel for like corporates that are looking to do, you know, retreats, team buildings. That was also starting to happen, you know, meetings. Your upmarket luxury sort of like markets that would go out of the continent, you know, were still now looking within the country, you know, in terms of experiences. And so that has also, you know, and as people, of course, prefer the privacy and exclusivity. So a lot of boutique properties, charter services, you know, have had, you know, faster recovery. Experiences are going mainstream, of course, because people want to go out. People want to experience new things. People want to connect and have that human contact. People are still getting married, having kids, celebrating anniversaries. So there is a lot of thematic and purpose-driven type travel, even in the absence of, you know, bigger events, festivals, and all these other things and conferences.
Fantastic stuff. Well, we're hopeful. We'll see how things go. Maybe we'll follow up with you, see how things happen. Muthuri Kinyamu, co-founder of Turnup Travel, thank you so much for your time.